a sold-out Meadowlands Arena in East Rutherford, New Jersey. The East Regional Final, top-seeded North Carolina, takes on second-seeded Cincinnati. The Tar Heels got here with a six-point win over Arkansas. Cincinnati outlasted Virginia. Good afternoon, everybody. I'm Byrne Lundquist along with Clark Kellogg. North Carolina with the top seed, a decided height advantage, symbolized by seven-footer Eric Montross.
Not only is he 7 feet and 275, but he possesses a nice, soft shooting touch as well.
The quickness of Cincinnati, I would think, is symbolized contrastingly by Nick Van Exel.
Well, he's the guy that makes them go, is streaky, but nonetheless makes big plays when they need them most.
These two teams are meeting for the first time since 1980. The winner goes to New Orleans and gets Kansas. Back with the lineups right after this.
CBS Sports exclusive coverage of the NCAA Basketball Championship Regional Final Game is sponsored by Honda, celebrating its 10th anniversary of automobile production in the United States. AT&T, the right choice. And by Diet Mountain Dew. You've never done nothing till you do Diet Dew. Yeah!
1,000 plus on hand at the Meadowlands. Right now, let's keep the starting lineups. Here is the public address announcer, Bill Bromberg.
Good afternoon, ladies and gentlemen, and welcome to the Meadowlands for today's regional championship game between the Cincinnati Bearcats and the North Carolina Tar Heels. Let's meet the starting lineups. At forward for Cincinnati, a 6'6 senior from Covina, California, number 4, Eric Martin. For North Carolina, a 6'6 junior from the Bronx, New York, number 31, Brian Reese. And forward for Cincinnati, a 6'6 senior from Long Beach, California, number 33, Terry Nelson. And forward for North Carolina, a 6'8 senior from Roanoke, Virginia, number 34, George Lynch. For Cincinnati, a 6'10 senior from Monrovia, California, number 44, Corie Blount. At center for North Carolina, a 7-foot junior from Indianapolis, Indiana, number 00, Eric Montross. At guard for Cincinnati, a 6'3 senior from Dothan, Alabama, number 10, Terrence Gibson. For North Carolina, a 6'4 junior from East Elmhurst, New York, number 14, Derek Phelps. At guard for Cincinnati, a 6'1 senior from Kenosha, Wisconsin, number 31, Nick Van Exel. At guard for North Carolina, a 6'3 sophomore from Garner, North Carolina, number 21, Donald Williams. Introducing the head coaches, for Cincinnati, Bob Huggins, and for North Carolina, Dean Smith.
Dean Smith now in his 32nd season, Bob Huggins in his 4th season at the age of 39. We've been joined by a third member of our broadcasting trio. Here is Andrea Joyce.
Well, Byrne, this Cincinnati team really feels it is the Rodney Dangerfield of college basketball. In their view, they get no respect, but that us against the world attitude has served them well. They're not intimidated by anyone. Ask Eric Martin about playing a school like North Carolina with a rich tradition of great players, and he points out, hey, Michael Jordan isn't out on that court today, Byrne.
All right, Andrea. North Carolina has won 8 regional finals. They're going after their 9th. That's 2nd in NCAA history. Cincinnati has been to the Final Four 5 times, most recently a year ago. 6 times, actually. They made 5 straight trips between 59 and 63. Jody Sylvester, Ed Valentine, and Art McDonald are the trio officials.
Well, you just saw Eric Montross, Corie Blount, one of the key matchups to watch. Cincinnati has to score early and often so they can get into that harassing pressure. They must rebound the ball well, especially on their defensive board. North Carolina, on the other hand, keep on keeping on. Handle the pressure, get it inside, wear Cincinnati down with your depth and your size.
North Carolina did handle Arkansas, but it was a tussle, and Arkansas presented the same kind of tempo that North Carolina will face in Cincinnati today. Here's Van Exel, and he dishes it too hard. Turnover, Derek Phelps, Lynch, 3-on-1, and Donald Williams has now scored 11 consecutive North Carolina points. He had the last nine in cinching that six-point victory over Arkansas Friday night. Gibson, nice pass back to Nelson, but he's not a scorer. Blount is. Not that time. Montrose, Phelps, Reese, short. And Corie Blount brings it down.
Corie Blount had a double-double on Friday, 19 points, 11 boards. Really important in their half-court game for Cincinnati to get Blount and Eric Martin some good touches early.
Van Exel has his first shot rim out. He had a tough shooting night Friday night after hitting his first two. There's the pass from Phelps. Reese with a shot too strong. In transition, Cincinnati. Off the foot of Eric Martin. Ryan Reese will... No, he won't throw.
Probably should have.
Gibson dishes to Martin for two.
Eric Martin has been fabulous of late. In three of his last five, he's had double-doubles, 19 points a game in the tournament.
Williams. And the baskets aren't falling early for North Carolina. We are tied at two. Here's Van Exel for three. He is, as you pointed out the other night, a very streaky shooter.
But he makes big plays when they need him, and if he gets it going, watch out, because he can give it to you in bunches.
Be North Carolina's ball. Van Exel in the tournament has not shot well.
There you see 10 for 41 from the field, but nonetheless he made two big threes in the game-turning run on Friday, and he's capable of those kinds of performances. He's a little streaky because he takes questionable shots on occasion, so it's hard to shoot a good percentage when you're manufacturing difficult shots.
That'll be goaltending called on Corie Blount.
Take a look at Montrose. He's just south of a seventh of a ton, but nonetheless, you'll see the Cincinnati Bearcats go right at him and try to double and triple team him inside.
Gibson for the Bearcats, and Cincinnati is out to a 7-4 lead.
Here's the pressure. They like to do it to you along the sideline.
At the other end, here's Van Exel.
Don't do that.
A runner. The kick is good. Terry Nelson gets it.
I don't know if North Carolina has seen as strong an offensive rebounding team as these Bearcats are. They attack the glass with vengeance.
Loose ball, Cincinnati. They'll slow it down.
You and I talked about how we knew Cincinnati would come out on their toes, not on their heels. This is a team that truly believes they can win and should win today.
Baseline, short, no good. 9-4, 16-45. The pace of the game, certainly what Cincinnati would have aspired to. That ball stripped. North Carolina gets it. First substitution of the game now for Cincinnati. Eric Martin comes back in, Terry Nelson. So it's Van Exel, Martin, Nelson. Bostic is also in the lineup, Curtis Bostic, number 43.
This is where North Carolina has to look to be patient. Cincinnati showing the zone on the baseline out of bounds.
Henrik Rodel is in, number five. They look inside for Montrose. He's being fronted by Blount. There's the pass and the block, but the foul comes with it.
Carolina doing what they want to do, get it to the big fella. Curtis Bostic hopping to it on the denial. But he had to come through Eric's body to block that shot. Montrose will get two free throws, and he's been outstanding for the last 2 weeks or so from the free throw line.
Those are a couple of fair examples of chiseled granite going at each other.
Oh, yeah. Nothing extra on Montrose's body, nor is there anything extra on Curtis Bostic's body either.
Montrose had been on a tear at the free throw line until the other night.
Mm-hmm.
And he was 3 of 6, so all of a sudden the problems have hit him. 0 for 2. Rebound, Lynch. Boss stick for Cincinnati. They lead it 9-4. Van Exel for three. Nope. Montross with a rebound. And North Carolina will play up tempo.
Really harassing pressure and quick hands by the Bearcats. Against that kind of pressure, you must be strong with the ball and knock down your mid-range jump shot.
Cat Sullivan off the bench gets two on the baseline. But you know what I sense early on, Clark, is a tenacity we didn't feel from Cincinnati the other night.
I think you're exactly right. And part of that, again, was because Cincinnati kind of got off to a little slow start scoring. They like to get into that pressure after they get some hoops. And here in the early going, they've gotten a couple of shots to go down for them.
Strong rebound for Curtis Foster.
They had 24 offensive rebounds the other night, and rebounding on the offensive glass more so than defensively is about quickness and timing, and Cincinnati has that in abundance.
A foul is called on Curtis Foster. That's his second.
Here you take a look at what Cincinnati does. Two Bearcats this offensive rebound.
Carolina Tar Heels trying to get back into the Final Four, first time since 91. Cincinnati was there a year ago where they lost to Michigan in the semifinals. A very close game. The winner of this game gets Kansas next Saturday in New Orleans. Phelps and Montross, there's a skip pass over to Sullivan, Rodell and George Lynch on the floor now for North Carolina.
Viewers, take a look at Blount and Montross inside. Try not to watch the ball all the time. The big guys doing damage to each other inside.
Sullivan gets another from the baseline. It's 11-8 Cincinnati. Terrence Gibson, Alan Jackson will not play today. The normal starting guard out with torn cartilage. Possible operation this week. Win or lose. As it was as of the other night, Van Exel chases down the loose ball. Van Exel, Nelson, Martin, Blount, and Gibson for Cincinnati right now.
Phelps guarding Martin right now.
That's for three. The lead is six.
Cincinnati does a nice job in their half-court defense as well. Everybody talks about their pressure, but the foundation of good pressure is good principles in your half-court game.
Quick pass from Phelps to Lynch, who is fouled. Bob Huggins, take a good look at the head of hair. You may not see it next week if Cincinnati wins.
Yeah, they're talking about shaving his dome. If, in fact, the Bearcats win today, I'd have to hang around for that. You know, he was an assistant coach my freshman year when I was at Ohio State. And to see him without any hair would be quite pleasurable.
Payback for all those
all that hollering and
exactly.
Suicides and all that.
Bob Huggins now in his fourth year.
Boy, he's done a great job, him and his staff, in getting this team to the level they played at the last 4 years, really, two NIT bids, and now a possible second trip to the Final Four in succession.
George Lynch will shoot one more.
This is a key element for North Carolina, the free throw game. They average about 9 more free throw attempts per game than the opposition, and it's a huge part of their success.
Here's the second of the 3 7-footers that North Carolina could put on the court. Kevin Salvadori comes in. He's a junior from Pittsburgh, number 33. So they've got a couple of trees in there now at Montross and Salvadori.
Well, two different looking trees. One is about 275, and the other one would be blown away in a hard wind.
One's a pine and one's an elk. Oh, not an elk. It's a Colorado background coming to front. One's an aspen. Let's get out of here. Williams, no. Oh, Blount hit it too hard. Back to Williams. Pump fake and a shot. No. And another rebound for Cincinnati.
Uh-oh, come up three.
Off the mark. And Reese has it for North Carolina. 14-10, Brian Reese. That was a two-pointer.
By playing this pace, it favors Cincinnati simply because you look at the number of shots both teams have gotten. Carolina really struggling, but it doesn't allow Carolina to take advantage of their size inside. When you go up and down, a lot of open shots present themselves early, and that's what's happened with Carolina. They've settled for the perimeter shot.
Blount will take it. Another offensive rebound. That's rejected, but it will be Cincinnati's ball. George Lynch gets about a minute rest, and he's back in the lineup. He'll replace Montross. In case you're wondering, the third seven-footer, if you don't know, is Matt Winston, who doesn't play all that much. ...14-10 with 12:43 to go. Both these teams blew away their first and second round opponents, and both had much more difficulty. Whoops, that's going to be a foul called on Carolina's Derek Phelps.
Yeah, Cincinnati has won their three tournament games by a margin of 27 per game. Only Kentucky is better. Here you take a look, Nelson, and then the little cross body block that time by Phelps.
Kentucky, of course, will go to New Orleans and take on either Michigan or Temple. Those two teams play in Seattle later this afternoon. And what a job John Chaney has done.
Oh, masterful. He's doing it pretty much with six, maybe six and a half players. And they lost Vic Karstarpin early in the season, who really is their only senior.
That'll interrupt your thought process.
It certainly will, as it should. One way you attack the zone is you throw over it, and then you go upstairs and get it. Turn it over. Eric Martin. And then at the other end, nice job by Carolina to attack after the made field goal. And Martin, the guy who flushed it at the other end, hustles back to prevent a hoop and force Reese to get two free throws.
Reese, a 68% free throw shooter on the season. His first of the day. Austin comes back in now, number 43. And Eric Martin will get a rest for the Cincinnati Bearcats.
I think a couple of things are going to happen for Carolina. Either one of two things has to happen. Either they have to take advantage of their size by dictating tempo a little more, or Dean Smith might have to go smaller to counteract the quickness of Cincinnati. Cincinnati, on the other hand, has to play the same way they've been playing and must avoid foul trouble of their frontline people.
Second chance points, a 9-0 edge for Cincinnati. That's the fourth Cincinnati turnover. We play under 12 minutes now. 16-12 Cincinnati. They have led throughout. They have never defeated North Carolina. The teams have played four previous times. The last was 13 years ago.
Little half-court trap here.
Loose ball, alertly tossed out, and here's Van Exel. He's going to have to pull up and bring it back out. Nelson is fouled by Lynch.
Well, good job by Terry Nelson to hold off Lynch and force him to commit that foul in his attempt for the steal.
Second team foul, time has been called. Cincinnati leads North Carolina here later this afternoon. Michigan or Temple will join Kentucky and Kansas in the Final Four in New Orleans. The Temple Owls, the lowest seed, still alive, and Kentucky has blown away every opponent, as Clark said.
Yeah, they've just drummed everybody. They do it because they're so deep and they knock down the threes. They pressure you defensively. They've got a wonderful one-on-one player in Jamal Mashburn.
Gibson, Van Exel, Blount, Martin, Terry Nelson. This is Nelson, number 33.
Zone defense here by Carolina, looking to trap.
Pretty good way to beat it.
Yeah, they shoot right over it. And that could be danger for the Tar Heels if Van Exel can stroke it like he has early.
He has equaled the number of three-point baskets he made the other night already this afternoon. Traveling. North Carolina turnovers. They committed only 3 turnovers in the second half against Arkansas the other night.
Well, that was certainly the best kind of preparation they could have gotten for what they would see today. And in the first half, Arkansas bothered them here in the first half. Cincinnati's pressure bothering North Carolina.
19-12, largest lead of the ball game. That's Lizelle Byrne, number 23, who's in the lineup now. And at the other end, here's Phelps. 10:30 remaining first half. Cincinnati comes in with a 27-4 mark. North Carolina 31-4. Montross, four hands on that play. Williams gets it back. Lynch kicks it out to Reese. Now to Phelps. Finally to Williams. How about this defense? Loose ball. Van Exel cannot control. Over and back.
Well, I tell you what, that's a tough call because Van Exel got a piece of the orange, but you can comment on it, Byrne. What about the D? They didn't allow anything easy, but let's take a look and see what happens here. Boy, that's a tough call.
Van Exel did have a hand on it.
And nobody really had possession. Certainly a Carolina player did not have control, which you need to have a backcourt violation.
Turnovers thus far, 6-4, North Carolina. Pat Sullivan comes in, and Henrik Rodel comes in off the bench. They join Montross, Lynch, and Phelps.
Cincinnati on that last possession did a great job of not allowing wing penetration by Carolina. Reese and Phelps love to penetrate off the wing, and that's one of the things Cincinnati wants to take away. Nick, don't show them everything in the first half.
Carolina trails 21-12 to a Cincinnati team that has forced thus far 7 turnovers for the Tar Heels. The Bearcats, the number 2 seed, jumped out to a 5-0 edge. They have not trailed. They lead by 9 right now, and Nick Van Exel already has 11, and now the lead is 11.
Beautiful cut by Van Exel, felt the pressure. And there you see Carolina with only 2 hoops in the last 8:15.
Gregor is on for Cincinnati. On the baseline, the ball is stripped and tipped out. It'll be North Carolina to throw it in.
He has shown us his ability to score. Now drop a dime for Eric Martin. And he knows how to finish in tight.
Back it comes to Lynch.
North Carolina has to spot up and shoot the perimeter shot. Not much penetration inside.
Whoa, what a play by Eric Martin. What a dandy play. Van Exel. Gregor. Over the back. Corie Blount with a foul.
Take a look at the quick hands, but look where his feet are. Excellent position by Martin. That's all orange, folks. Although Martin may have gotten away with the walk there. But I think the official may be distracted by how good that play was.
I don't want to say he walked, but he was halfway to the Lincoln Tunnel.
Yeah, he shuffled a bit, but the reason Cincinnati is able to make so many deflections, people want to say quick hands. Yes, that's half of it, but you've got to get your feet in position so your hands can do what?
Yes. And that, for the moment, restores the calm to Carolina.
One thing about North Carolina is they continue to play. They may look flustered momentarily, but eventually they'll idle down and smooth it out. And they throw so many people at you that they're eventually able to get back into their style of play.
Van Exel, Gregor, Lizelle, Burton, and Montross with a wild elbow.
Yeah, the big fella is an easy target at 7 feet. And when you get that chicken wing up into the throat of an opposing player, that's a no-brainer call. Take a look. Middle of your screen, 00. Gregor trying to set the pick. See, that's a chicken wing that's a little aggressive.
Chicken Hawk. Sullivan, he is out. Williams back in along with Reese, Lynch, Montross, and Phelps. And for Cincinnati, they've got Van Exel. This is Keith Greger, freshman from Cincinnati. Eric Martin, Terrence Gibson, and Terry Nelson. Nelson with the ball.
Good spacing here by Cincinnati. They'll spread you out and try to beat you off the dribble.
In the ball game. He is 4 of 7 from three-point range. Almost taken away by Gibson. Now Cincinnati has it. 9 Carolina turnovers. This is a Cincinnati team, excuse me, Clark, that forces 21 turnovers per game.
They're so quick with their hands and feet that you've got to take the medium-range jump shot, Byrne. You can't try to shoehorn it inside because they won't give you room. I think Dean Smith is going to have to look at putting some water on Nick Van Exel. The fire is raging wild.
The lead is 15. The elbows are flying. And the call is going to go against Keith Greger. Nick Van Exel has erupted. 5 3-point baskets like this. 17 total points. Cincinnati is up by 15.
You are watching the NCAA Basketball Championship on CBS.
Carolina now down by 15. Dean Smith electing to wait for the television timeout. Some might wonder why he didn't call a timeout earlier.
Well, if you've watched Carolina over the years, Dean Smith archives his timeouts. He saves them until the very end of the game. And typically, when a guy gets going, you figure you can ride it out. And when you get into the TV timeout zone, sometimes it's best just to save
it. Yeah, Nick Van Exel will shoot free throws now. There is his dad. Has to be thrilled with what he has seen from his son so far today.
Having played and with my dad still alive, I know Nicky Sr.'s heart is coming through his chest right now.
Eric Montross, second personal foul. Van Exel, first free throw shot of the day. Pat Sullivan comes back in for the Tar Heels. Brian Reese gets a rest. Phelps, Montross, Sullivan, Lynch, and Williams, Carolina.
Well, this is a very good start for Cincinnati. Remember, in the history of North Carolina basketball, they have some fabulous comebacks. One this year against Florida State when they were down 20 and stormed back to win. So they actually were down 22 in that game. So they're by no means out of there.
No, and I don't think anyone here feels that way. They've now cut the lead to 30 to 18. Here's Greger. And there's a turnover. It will be, however, Cincinnati ball. Last touch by North Carolina.
It's important for Carolina as you look at Bob Huggins to really try to get this down to a manageable margin.
Foul away from the ball on George Lynch. Second, or Greger it is, not Lynch. It was the second on Greger, so it went against Cincinnati.
Well, hey, I'm talking about a manageable margin, Byrne. It's really only a 4-possession game right,
right
now. I felt like it was a little more than 12 until I looked up at the scoreboard. So Carolina in excellent shape. And again, with the foul situation the way it is, Carolina shoots free throws the rest of the half on common fouls. Even more reason for them to try to throw it inside.
And when you say excellent shape, you mean in the context of a 40-minute ball.
Right, exactly.
Tip back. Here's Gibson. And a turnover for Cincinnati. That is their sixth.
Cincinnati substitution number 32, Mike Harris.
Mike Harris will enter the game now. Junior from Brooklyn. for Cincinnati. Turned it over 9 times, and Cincinnati has gotten 12 points off those 9.
So quick math tells you that's a 67% conversion rate. You can make a living on that.
Montross, finally they whip it underneath the Lynch. What a defensive job by Eric Martin that forced him to alter his shot, but now the ball gets loose. Martin was way up in the air. The lead is 10.
Well, that's a big turnaround, because after that defensive play, Cincinnati had numbers, and the turnover allowed Carolina to get a hoop. You know, North Carolina not a bad half-court trapping team themselves.
Good interior passing, and Harris will shoot free throws.
I think they may have caught that one on the floor.
Did indeed. So before the shot, foul was on Williams, his first and only the 15th foul. So inbounded now by Vic Van Exel. Minutes to go, first half. Cincinnati has led throughout. Largest margin was 15 just a few moments ago. Nelson, the Bostic rather, here's Van Exel. NBA range. That is beyond the white line.
You've got to mark him and tag him. Otherwise, he's going to hurt you. That'll hurt you, too.
Mike Harris wanted no part of that.
Cincinnati a little confused, lost track of Montross. I don't know how you do that. I don't know how you forget where the big fella is.
One of those big buildings across the Hudson. Oh, this is New York.
Numbers.
Back it comes to Gibson. He'll shoot it. Montross will rebound it. And then North Carolina has it knocked out by Cincinnati. Now John Jacobs, number 55, will come in for Cincinnati, replacing Mike Harris. Harris had one shot to stay with Montross and didn't. And it's by your leave back on the bench.
Yeah, and he's getting an earful from Coach Huggins right now.
Who will give you an earful?
And he will repeat it. As we read in this morning's New York Times, Coach Huggins learned from a teacher of his long ago that repetition is the key to effective teaching.
4 minutes to go, first half of play. That's 10 Carolina turnovers in the first half.
I think Cincinnati has to keep a double-digit lead at the break to feel confident about how they play. On the other hand, North Carolina would like to get it into single figures.
Traveling. 3 minutes and 38 seconds remaining in the first half. Cincinnati's lead is 11.
Never before. Announcing the global alliance of U.S. Air and British Airways. Now, there are no boundaries.
Toyota trucks are powerful. Toyota trucks are affordable. It's Toyota's Simply Irresistible sales event. Toyota, the best-selling 4x4 compact pickup in America 13 years running. Right now, your Toyota dealer has option package savings and big factory-to-dealer incentives on a great selection of trucks. Even the hot all-new Toyota T100. A bigger Toyota that puts you in a whole new class of truck. See your Toyota dealer now.
Why use Valvoline Motor Oil? For their race cars and their own cars, Valvoline is the number one choice of race mechanics from Indy 500 to Daytona 500 to NHRA to Baja to SCCA.
Now in Goodyear, you can save 50% on the second tire when you buy one tire at the regular price. That's half off Goodyear Premium All-Season Radials for cars and light trucks. Any way you look at it, you save. Only at Goodyear now.
Final piece of the puzzle to be solved after our game, the West Regional Final from Seattle. Jim and Billy are out there for Temple against Michigan.
Well, I tell you what, Byrne, if Michigan has two or three lapses in that game, it could end their run. They're going to have to play 40 solid minutes of basketball to handle that young and confident Temple squad. It's
been kind of hard to get Michigan's attention in this tournament, hasn't it?
Certainly seems to be that way.
Van Exel has been on a tear, 6 of 10 from three-point range. He's on defense right now. The turnovers, 10 so far in the first half. And North Carolina's averaged only 10 in the tournament. Good job by Montross.
Nice catch and finish. And that's one of the things that really impresses you about Eric Montross. Obviously, his size is what jumps out at you. But he's got pretty good, soft hands.
Eric Martin, nice reverse layup, but too strong. And Van Exel chases it down. Was the finish.
Yes!
Was that high enough?
Oh, he didn't do that!
Was that high enough?
Oh, my!
And Montross got poked in the eye. My goodness, was he up in the air.
How high did Curtis Bostic go to get that rebound? We see the tail end and then a nice feed, and Montross is down prior to that action.
Montross will get a rest, poked in the eye.
And there's Mr. Montross, Scott.
You talk about hopping to it. Watch Curtis Bostic. This ball goes up above the basket, and look at him rise and claim it, and then dished it to Martin for the deuce.
35-24, back to a double-digit lead. Reese has it knocked away, and the putback is good by George Lynch. So Carolina now trailing by 9 with 2:34 to go first half. They have not led in the ballgame. Cincinnati jumped out to a 5-0 edge. Here's Terry Nelson. Bostic. Short with the shot, but he gets the rebound. Now, will he put it up again? Of course. And it won't go. The lead is 7.
Right there in the neighborhood now. And he knew it was coming.
For 3. Lynch. Cincinnati got a little sloppy and paid big time.
You like Carolina size, depth, and you love the way this guy attacks the orange on the offensive glass. George Lynch getting vocal as well. As a senior, that's expected. When you look at him on his way to another double-double.
Had 10 rebounds the other night to become the second all-time leading rebounder in the storied history of North Carolina University. And the lead is 4. The foul was on Nelson, by the way.
Critical juncture here because Cincinnati now has to deal with a different game. They were in control most of this half. Now Carolina has the momentum. How do you weather this storm?
Martin. Foul on Blount. Third foul on Blount. 19th foul. 1-1.
Are you looking at Eric Montross? Ice on the eye. He'll be back, though.
At the half, Pat O'Brien, Mike Francesa, and Digger Phelps. John Thompson will be in the coach's corner. We'll have a live interview with Roy Williams of the Kansas Jayhawks. Bearcats down with his third foul, and what was a 15-point lead at the seven-minute mark has evaporated.
And with Corie Blount now having three fouls, that could be large when we get to the next 20 minutes.
Derek Phelps will shoot one more. Phelps eased the pain for Montross for the moment.
And also to try to keep any swelling down that might be thinking about propping up. Carolina just stays within themselves. They maintain their poise so well. They're a little flustered and rattled in the first 12 or 13 minutes, but just continue to scratch and claw and fight, and now they've tightened it up.
They have got 12 points off the Cincinnati lead.
Well, I think you got to try to find Van Exel. Carolina in a man-to-man. They'll look to crowd him at every opportunity.
Wow. One of those shots Bob Huggins has learned to live with.
Mm-hmm.
Van Exel with the foul.
Donald Williams is excellent off the dribble, and here he penetrates. Van Exel made a good play up top, but fouled Williams with the body. There's Huggins and Van Exel in conversation. Van Exel was quoted at yesterday's press conference as saying that every now and then I have to tune Coach Huggins out. And when Bob Huggins was asked about that, well, he said, I know he listens because I tell him enough times.
Donnie Calabria comes in, and now a chance for the tie, which would mean that North Carolina doesn't get it. They would have outscored Cincinnati by 15 in the last 6 minutes.
Well, because of their depth and their ability to defend, they're able to put together runs like that.
35-34. Bostic had Martin. Lynch takes it away. And then Bostic fouls him. He joins one to three.
And that's one of the things Cincinnati could ill afford, front line foul trouble. And that's obviously one of the things that North Carolina wants to do to the opposition, get them in foul trouble and get those free throw opportunities.
Lazelle Durden checks in, replaces Bostic. Here's a, you said it would be a big part of this ball game.
Well, it always is with North Carolina. They do such a great job shooting free throws and getting big volume. I mean, they average 13 more free throw attempts than the opposition on a game-by-game basis. So it's a major part of why they're so successful.
Lynch. We're tied at 35.
Well, he just gets in there and does work, George Lynch. Doesn't get the acclaim he deserves. As good an offensive rebounder at his size as I've seen in college basketball. And he's a good, solid defender as well.
And with 37.6 seconds remaining in the first half, the Tar Heels, the top seed in the East, have their first lead of the ball game. No shot clock for the remainder of the half.
Nick Van Exel has to be careful picking up his dribble too soon. Got to keep the bounce alive until he's ready to get it to a receiver.
Oh, boy, what a screen Nelson set.
Well, this could be devastating if Cincinnati goes in on the bottom side of the scoreboard.
Nelson is not a shooter, but he gets a big basket.
I think that's huge. As long as they play for the first 12 or 13 minutes, to go in trailing would have been tremendously demoralizing for Cincinnati.
That's the end of the first half with the score 37-36 Cincinnati. Matt O'Brien, Mike Francesa, Digger Phelps, along with Prudential Securities at the half. After this word and a message from your local station.
CBS Sports exclusive coverage of the NCAA Basketball Championship Regional Final Game is sponsored by Buick and your local Buick dealers. Remember Buick, the new symbol for quality in America. O'Doul's, no alcohol, 70 calories and real beer taste. O'Doul's, what beer drinkers drink when they're not drinking beer. And by Arid XX, the antiperspirant that helps keep you extra, extra dry. CBS Sports exclusive coverage of the NCAA Basketball Championship Regional Final Game is sponsored by the Heartbeat of America Chevrolet and your local Chevy dealer. RCA, number one with the toughest critics in the world. And by Mutual of New York, celebrating 150 years of money for life.
Eric Montross injured in the eye late in the first half. For an update, let's go to Andrea Joyce.
Actually, Vern, he got elbowed right underneath the eye, and it caused his eyes to tear up. They put some ice on it during that late minutes in the first half. That's all they did in halftime. They just put more ice on it, and they say he will play in the second half. Now, as far as Cincinnati is concerned, they're not that concerned about losing a 15-point lead. They feel if they can keep the ball on the side of the court and not in the middle and keep Carolina off the line, they'll be able to increase that lead again. Vern?
All right, Andrea, do you think they should be concerned with losing that lead?
No, I really don't think so. I think it would have been more concerned had they not regained the lead. I mean, they still are on top, obviously not by as many as they were earlier. But the key issue, again, is to keep Carolina off the foul line and to get some solid shooting from other guys. I mean, Corie Blount was 0-4. I think he's got to get involved in the offense this half.
See, the Cincinnati behind Van Exel, 17 first 13-minute points, jumped out to that huge lead of 15 points. And then Montross and Lynch led the way back. They had 17 of the last 22 Carolina points. 37-36, the winner goes on to New Orleans, where they take on Kansas next week. And later this afternoon, Michigan and Temple for the final spot in the Final Four. Williams, the runner, and the rebound. Terry Nelson can't hang on, but Lynch has it go off his hands, and Cincinnati will get the ball. Let's set the lineups for you. Van Exel, 21 first half points. Blount playing with three fouls. Martin is in the lineup, so is Nelson and Terrence Gibson. For Carolina, here's the trap. Phelps, Lynch, Reese, Montross, and Williams are starting five. Blount, good pump fake. Chases down the loose ball after he had gotten the rebound. Williams. Martin with the defensive job. Montross gets it back. Now George Lynch. And Gibson gets the rebound.
Boy, you really got to squeeze the orange when you go in traffic because both teams have extremely active hands. Line of the man-to-man. They'll show you a lot of different defenses.
The wonderful one-touch pass by Terry Nelson.
Little high-low action. Anytime you can get the ball to the middle of the floor from the wing, that defender inside is over the top, and if you whip it down inside quickly, you've got the nice little two-man game. And you take a look at the tail end of it. Nelson just lofted it inside to Martin. He does a nice job of drawing the foul.
Foul was on Reese, his first. And Eric Martin, the senior from Covina, California, gets the first of his two.
He and Corie Blount were junior college teammates. How would you like to have that squad?
Pretty good California connection for Cincinnati.
They're all business out there on the court, too.
Goes back to the point we made at the beginning of the day. The Cincinnati team really playing with a chip on the shoulder, eh? In part because of all the JC transfers. Here's Montross. They feel they've not been acknowledged as an outstanding basketball team around the country.
Well, they're certainly playing well enough to earn that kind of respect now. They feel like the Final Four would solidify it.
39-38. Great decision.
Excellent choice by Van Exel. He knew defenders were coming at him because of how hot he's been from the perimeter, and then got Blount inside.
That's Blount's first basket of the day. Here's Lynch, and he is fouled by Gibson.
Take a look at North Carolina. Good, unselfish ball movement here. Nice touch. Reach to Montross. Mark it up. Now Cincinnati at the other end. You see Montross leave to challenge Van Exel. That leaves Blount alone on the backside.
And the points in the paint thus far, 20 for North Carolina, 12 for the Bearcats. George Lynch at the line, where he is 5 of 6 today. With another quietly effective afternoon.
Boy, he brings his work clothes and attitude every night.
Williams guarding Terrence Gibson. There's a no call on Nelson. Blount. Oh, good job by Lynch again. Here's Lynch at the offensive end. Short. Blount with a rebound. Cincinnati in transition, but Carolina back.
When you've got numbers, that's one of the best times to shoot the three in transition.
The lead is 4, Cincinnati.
Timeout, Carolina.
Timeout, Carolina. Dean Smith has a word or two for the officiating crew.
There are cars with advanced engine. There are cars with advanced engineering. There are cars that make you comfortable. There are cars that are well protected. There are cars that protect their occupants well. There are cars equipped the way you want. And cars that are easy to own now. Which one should be your new car? All of the above. Chevy Lumina Euro Sedan. Test drive a Chevy Lumina Euro today at your neighborhood Chevrolet dealer.
Turnover, he called the timeout. Dean Smith felt like he had gotten bumped, and certainly there was some contact, but a pretty wise move there by Williams, because it seemed like it was going to be a turnover had he not whistled the timeout.
44-40, Rutherford is in the lineup now for North Carolina. Takes the shot off the glass and in. And the lead is 2, 44-42. Henrik Rutherford, senior from Germany. And an all-ACC academic player. Today's game, Clark and I will select a Chevrolet player of the game from each team. Chevrolet donates a $1,000 scholarship to the general scholarship fund of each school. Last foul was on Henrik Rutherford, his first, second team foul. And Bob Huggins working the official. And now timeout is called by the Cincinnati Bearcats. So both teams have wasted a timeout here in this half.
There are two ways to put a movie theater in your home. You could build one. Or you could simply buy the giant 35-inch RCA home theater with SRS sound. It's the easiest way to get a movie theater in your home. Now, get up to $100 back on selected RCA home theater televisions.
Like a rock. I got an 88 Chevrolet Silverado with 304,000 miles. I drive it to work 125 miles one way to work, 304,000 miles. Still rolling.
I got approximately 353,000 miles on this truck. It runs 10 or 12 hours a day, 6 days a week. It's always brought us in, you know, regardless of where we was or what we was doing.
Chevrolet, the most dependable, longest-lasting trucks on the road.
Keep tires on it. Keep gas in it. It'll go.
Ours is truly an amazing planet. 169 countries, 24 time zones, and 1,700 American Express travel offices worldwide. In places like Kuala Lumpur or Sri Lanka. Actually, there's two there. So you can replace plane tickets, traveler's checks, a lost card, even in Abu Dhabi.
But you can't get your mail forwarded there.
And as a matter of fact, you can. Now, with a Visa card, you could probably get help at some foreign bank. But with American Express, you can get help virtually everywhere on the globe. Well, not everywhere.
He did what?
If this reminds you of the level of productivity in your office,
bonehead,
there's something you should know.
It is. Who got the paper stuck in there?
I just put new paper in.
How'd you do this?
Byers Lab gave every Mita copier they tested their highest rating for uptime. So if you want a more productive office,
timeout because of good denial. Nobody was on the ball at all for Carolina. That's why they were able to deny. They had 5-on-4.
And when I say both teams wasted a timeout, I mean in the sense that those timeouts will not be available for their use later in the ballgame. They had to use them. Turnover, Cincinnati. That's number 13 for the Bearcats. 39-year-old Bob Huggins is aging before our eyes.
I want you to do that to you.
Underneath, Montross was there. And so was Martin with the foul. So Eric Montross goes to the line. That's the second foul on Martin, the second team foul of this half. Winner gets Kansas next week in the Final Four semis in New Orleans. Coming up next, Michigan against Temple from Seattle. The winner of that game will take on a torrid Kentucky team in the other semifinal game. There's Montross for one. And again this year, Clark, the four number ones don't make it. All of them. Eric Montross's father. It's 44-0. Third foul on Montross. Will Dean Smith make a move?
He's thinking about it. I don't think he will right now, but he does have Salvadori and Sullivan. Salvadori, Winstrom hasn't played much. He may just go smaller, which might not be a bad lineup. They made a pretty good push late in that half when Montross went out with the eye injury.
That may be what he's got in mind. No, it's Rodel for Williams. So he's smaller, but not in the position we thought he would go. Rodel is out, Williams back in. Blount gets 46-44.
There's the pressure by Cincinnati. Three quarters court.
There's that quick step you talked about Friday night.
Almost impossible to stop once he gets into the 6-foot area because he elevates so well on his shot.
Bostic. On the baseline, Bostic again. Double ball, possession arrow, Cincinnati.
Uses the last dribble to explode himself up in the air and then the nice gentle touch. He has really come to master that little 4-foot baseline shot, which is really a tough shot when your body is going full speed. Go get it, Corie! Beautiful pass and execution. Just threw it over the top.
Cincinnati by two. Van Exel with the steal. Two on one, Phelps is back defensively. And caused Dan Exel to alter his shot, and now the ball goes to Carolina.
Well, good transition defense by North Carolina. Take a look. Phelps back. You wonder if Van Exel, he probably had a chance to give it up, but Lynch making the hustle back. Good challenge without fouling by Phelps. Well, I don't know if Lynch didn't touch that last.
Blocking foul on Bostic or Nelson. Who is it underneath? It's Bostic, and that's his fourth. And quickly, Bostic will go out. Nelson comes in.
One clean dome for another.
Hoping to have someone join him in the form of Bob Huggins when all this is over. 48-46. Williams. 2 points.
Well, his stroke is as smooth and sweet as Miss Buttersworth.
7 points for Williams. Tied at 48 with 14:38 to go.
Well, I think maybe you try to throw it inside, attack Montrose.
There's Van Exel, who was fouled by Lynch, I believe. Yes, it is George Lynch. That's his second and the fourth team foul on North Carolina.
I made the point about maybe you throw it into Blount because Montrose has the four fouls, and see if you can take a possession or two to maybe pick up that fourth one on it.
The steal by Derek Phelps.
One dribble too many by Gibson.
50-48, 14-10 to go. Reese passes on the shot. Back to Williams. He'll take it. Gets out. North Carolina ball.
This is like throwing the out pattern in football. Take a look at Martin. He just runs to the goal. Van Exel could never see Eric Martin. He just expected him to be there. Threw it to a spot. Beautiful execution.
Brian Reese and George Lynch will get rest now for North Carolina. Pat Sullivan's in, along with Kevin Salvadori. And Terrence Gibson is out. Eric Martin is talking things over with the officiating crew here.
Fellas.
Salvadori will inbound. 2-point Cincinnati lead. Phelps, Montrose, Williams, Sullivan, and Salvadori for North Carolina. Sullivan. Air ball. Van Exel. Lizelle Durden is on the court now for Cincinnati, along with Van Exel, who has not scored in this half. He had 21 at halftime. Sullivan knocks it out of bounds. Cincinnati will inbound. Eric Martin, Corie, Blount, Nelson, Durden, and Van Exel on the floor for Cincinnati.
Well, both of these teams playing with so much intensity.
George Lynch will give Montrose a rest.
And here you see Montrose going to get a break. He has the three fouls. And Carolina gets a little smaller, although Salvadori is out there, and he just picked up a foul.
That is the first on Salvadori and the fifth team foul of the half.
Cincinnati with only three, so they may be able to get Carolina into the bonus here and give themselves an advantage here early in the second half.
Van Exel, 6 of 10 from three-point range in the game, and Phelps. Oh, who'd they get? Nelson? No, it's on Blount, 44. And that's is for. Not Nelson.
Blount going to have to sit down now, and he's replaced by Bostic, who also has four.
Remaining in the game. Sullivan, Salvadori taken away by Van Exel. 13 turnovers for North Carolina. Van Exel finds the jumper. That is for two.
How about the crossover dribble that tripped up the defender?
4-point Cincinnati lead. First basket of this half for Van Exel. Williams will run it in. Take it off the glass for two.
You have to honor his three-point shot, and he might even be a better off-the-dribble shooter. He loves to shoot it after two or three dribbles into the lane.
There's Van Exel. Just one lead in this ball game. That was late in the first half by a point. They have a chance to tie or take the lead on this possession. Back to Salvadori, left-handed jumper. No, that's Sullivan. Strong move, but the shot won't fall. The rebound by Lynch.
He's always around the orange, and when he gets it, he usually doesn't let it go. Boy, Martin had that rebound and tried to snap it too hard and lost it.
From Van Exel. Williams. For three, Eric Martin rebounds Cincinnati, 54-52.
We got a long way to go, Byrne, but how big was that basket at the end of the half for Cincinnati?
Nelson, who hit that basket.
That gave Cincinnati the lead going into halftime after Carolina had come back from 15 down.
And it happened so long ago that I forgot Carolina did lead 2-0. They did get the first basket of the game. Foul on Phelps. 54-52. Gregor gets the inbound ball. Keith Gregor, the freshman. Bostic is in.
Well, nice time to take Van Exel out. Not only do you give him this quick blow, but the next dead ball is a timeout as well, so he'll get additional rest.
He's got eight. 57-52. Van Exel ready to come back in. Williams.
A honey sweet stroke and the confidence to go with it. Does no good to have that stroke if you don't look to pull the trigger at every opportunity. Cincinnati has shot the ball. They're all draped up in the paint, which may be surprising because they're not nearly as big as Carolina, and then they've had tremendous success beyond the arc.
Curtis Bostic has fouled out of the ball game with 10:21 remaining.
Here we take a look at the foul. Good give and go here. Gregor from Bostic. Montrose gets a piece of it from behind, and Bostic comes in over the top of Brian Reese, and that is... There are no good fifth fouls, but that certainly is one that he didn't get his money's worth.
Gregor and Nelson, Martin, Van Exel back in, and Gibson now for Cincinnati. Yeah. We're tied. Stripped by Phelps. Reese has it. At the other end. Wild shot. Controlled by Eric Martin. Gibson. Lynch with another rebound. And Carolina with a chance to reclaim the lead.
Wrap it up, Byrne. They're hooping big time out there. Both ends of the floor.
Winner gets Kansas. Michigan Temple play later today. Great pass. Lynch. Too strong with the shot. For Martin. Lynch is running him. Van Exel gets the screen, kicks it left side. Gibson, no. Martin and Montrose battle, and Carolina gets it.
Boy, Bobby Huggins can't believe there was no foul call. Martin got grabbed pretty good as he came up with the rebound. Take a look. Right in the middle of your screen, watch Martin get a piece of this ball. And then Lynch had a piece of his neck. Montrose had his right arm. No fracture, no foul.
8:24 remaining. Tied at 57. At one point, with 7 minutes to go in the first half, Cincinnati was up by 15 points. Carolina came back to lead by one until a last-second basket by Terry Nelson gave Cincinnati a lead they have not relinquished. They have been tied, as we are now, three or four times in this half.
The ball well. So he gets his hand in there, maybe a little contact. Good play here on the tie up. Well, I like the fact they're really letting them play. It's been consistent. I mean, both ends, they're allowing the guys for some contact to allow them to play. And well, you couldn't ask for anything more in regards to how it's been called.
Carolina has the lead, and they've scored the last 7 points. Terrific pass and couldn't put it in.
Everything but the period on that sentence. Excellent execution.
7 minutes and 36 seconds remaining in the game. Carolina by a deuce.
A tradition unlike any other. The Masters on CBS.
We live forever through our deeds, the lives we touch, and what we leave behind. In 1843, a company dedicated itself to that proposition, and it did so by writing the nation's first mutual life insurance policy. That company was Mutual of New York, and we're still in the business of insuring long and prosperous futures. After all, we've been looking forward for the past 150 years.
Accidents before they start. What else would you expect from the heartbeat of America?
You are watching the NCAA Basketball Championship on CBS.
Carolina has scored the last seven. They lead by two, 7:36 to go. And coming up next, Temple against Michigan. An owl and a Wolverine having at it. Don't do that often. But they will. And the winner goes down to New Orleans for the Final Four, where they will join Kansas and Kentucky in the winner of this game. Possession arrow now favors Cincinnati. Here's Phelps with Salvadori and Montross. Sullivan's back on the court, and so is Ronald Williams. Offensive foul on Montross. That's four on him.
Let's take a look. You see the big fella strapped on the sideline. Well, Eric Martin got away with some contact, but they whistled Montross for the elbow foul. Actually, he was just being strong with the basketball. Sometimes when you're 7 feet tall, it's much easier to appear to foul somebody than actually foul.
Van Exel has only 2 points in this half, 21 at halftime.
Well, you know, he was very much talked about in the North Carolina locker room. Phelps and Williams doing a pretty good job on it.
Martin, too strong. Salvadori rebound.
That's his shot, though.
North Carolina, 28 rebounds. Cincinnati, 28. Dead heat in that category.
And the pace has slowed down significantly since the first half. And now it becomes a rock'em sock'em type of game. Who can exert their will and make free throws down the stretch?
Phelps. Salvadori with the putback. He's one of the 2 7-footers playing down low.
My dad has always told me, good big will eventually outdo good little. We'll see if that is true, as many other things he's told me have proved out to be true.
I hope we're restricting that to basketball.
Yeah. Oh.
Okay. Basket and a free throw.
They won't go away. Eric Martin, beautiful bounce pass. That's the only way that ball gets there. And Gregor gets it up and down.
North Carolina with a 12-point advantage. In close. And Keith Gregor goes to the line.
Nice job by the Bearcats to come back to the freshman. On their last half-court possession, he got a good look, didn't finish. But that didn't stop Martin from finding him inside underneath.
Miss Myers on the free throw. North Carolina up by 2, 6 minutes remaining. Winner goes to New Orleans, where they take on the Kansas Jayhawks. North Carolina trying to go back for a ninth time to the Final Four. Their last national championship, the only one under Dean Smith, in 1982 in New Orleans. A guy named Jordan hit a jumper in that game. John Thompson remembers it, and he just winced in the studio. Offensive foul, Brian Reese.
That almost caused Dean Smith to lose a shoe.
Second foul on Reese. Ninth team foul.
Here you take a look. He lowered that shoulder. And typically that puts you in a vulnerable position for the offensive foul when you dip that shoulder.
Van Exel shoots it. Rebound Nelson. Gibson pump fake and the shot. Cincinnati by a point. The pick from Montross.
They got numbers.
5-on-4. Montross misses the jam.
Excellent recognition by Carolina. Van Exel took a spill and was late getting back into the defense. Inside to Reese. Actually, Lynch find the weak side open guy, and Montross just didn't quite finish.
Foul is on Gibson, his second. As we said, Montross had been shooting free throws with exceptional skill early in the tournament. Struggled the other night, 3 of 6. Today he is 2 of 4.
Yep.
Sometimes tough being a pop.
Oh, my goodness. I'd say. We got the easiest job, Byrne, you and I. We get to sit here, enjoy it, talk about it.
The sigh helped. Tied at 62.
Carolina in the zone now. Protecting Montross. He's got the four fouls.
Eric Martin. Nelson, they look for Gregor. Cincinnati retains possession. 4:40 to go, tied at 62.
Both of these teams have changed their defenses effectively. John Thompson talked about that at the half. Cincinnati against this zone has to keep the ball out of the corners, try to center the basketball.
Oh, good move. And then the shot a little too strong. On the floor is Nelson, finds Van Exel. He'll shoot it. No. Carolina ball. His dad is encouraging Nick Van Exel.
Cincinnati staying in the zone. They've got to protect Blount and also try to keep the ball out of the paint. Blount also with four fouls. But they have to keep an eye on Donald Williams, who can spot up and pull the trigger on the three. And then the other thing you have to do is get to the board. Out of the zone, you almost have to just attack the ball.
Six on the shot clock, and Williams hits it.
Man, he's got a beautiful stroke. I could come to the gym and just watch him practice shooting the ball.
He practices a lot. Cincinnati has hit only two of its last 11 from the field. They're down by two. Van Exel, 21 points in the first half, only two in the second stanza. Nelson kicks it back to Gibson.
The zone is not allowing much dribble penetration.
That's off the mark. Terry Nelson chases it down. Carolina ball. Remaining. Carolina by two.
Out here, we work part-time and play full-time.
I was 18, didn't have a care. Working for peanuts, not a dime to spare.
To get the most fun out of every dollar, get into Chevy S10 pickup for around $8,000. From Chevrolet, the most dependable, longest-lasting trucks on the road.
There's cause for celebration. It's the opening of the latest ITT Sheraton Hotel. Sheraton is now the ultimate global hotel chain for business travelers, with 420 hotels, inns, resorts, and all suites, and one high standard of service in over 60 countries. What does ITT bring to the party? $1 billion worth of improved systems, services, and renovations. ITT, we're adding more than just our name.
What we need now is the beach.
And the brew. And the bay.
Still going. Nothing outlasts the Energizer battery. It keeps going and going.
Say goodbye to the forest. The beaches. The wetlands. From now on, you play golf where it was meant to be played. On fresh-cut grass. Introducing the Top Flight Magna. It's actually larger to reduce hooks and slices, and it's the longest, straightest, softest distance ball yet. The new Top Flight Magna. It's not just a new ball. It's a whole new game.
For his retirement, Neil McBain had no intention of slowing down. That's why Dean Witter mapped out his financial course with only one goal in mind. Victory. Dean Witter.
We measure success one investor at a time.
It's a weekend of championship basketball, starting with the NCAA Women's Final Four next Saturday on CBS Sports.
Carolina by two, a little more than three to go on the last possession. Hustle by Lynch forced that ball off Terry Nelson before it went out of bounds, and Carolina has possession.
Carolina trailed by 15, 7 minutes into the game, 29-14. They trailed by one at the half. They were down by five a few moments ago, then scored seven unanswered points, and they lead by two right now. 2:45 to go. Lynch and Williams, who has 9 points in this half, along with Phelps, Montross, and Brian Reese. There's Williams, free for the shot, no. Lynch is there for the offensive board and the putback. Reese chases it down. Carolina with a fresh 45 and 2:19 remaining.
That's what scares Bobby Huggins in going to the zone, is that you leave a guy like Lynch loose on the weak side board, and more times than not, he'll make you pay.
Montross gets it back out to Williams. 10 on the shot clock. Foul is called on Martin. That's four on Eric Martin. He joins Corie Blount with four, and Boston's already out. Cincinnati has had the edge in three-point shooting, but Carolina a decided advantage in close. Van Exel, 21 of those points in the first half. And George Lynch, another effective day, 19 points and 10 rebounds. And now Brian Reese at the free throw line. Martin's fourth foul.
That means he and Blount both now with four. For Carolina, Montross, I think, the only one with four.
Brian Reese has 7 points in the game, and he's perfect so far on three free throws.
Well, you're looking at going down by four if he makes this, so you need a good shot if you're Cincinnati, whether it's a two or a three. You need a good look. You need a good, solid possession here.
Lead is four. Zone defense for North Carolina.
That means it might be tough to get it inside. You've got to move it and spot up for a good three from a good shooter.
Still has only 2 points in this half. But Brian Reese is called for the foul underneath.
Eric Martin sneaking inside again. Both teams, because they're playing zone defenses, vulnerable to offensive rebound. Take a look at Martin. See, he gets inside, anticipates where the shot is coming off, and beats Reese to the ball.
Third foul on Reese. 10th team foul. So Cincinnati is shooting two. Eric Montross playing with four fouls, as he has for much of this half. Bostic has already fouled out. Blount and Martin with four each. Montross, the only one in trouble for North Carolina. 2-point lead, 1:26 remaining.
Cincinnati must defend, force a tough shot, and rebound, all that without fouling. Plenty of time on the clock.
Carolina has done a terrific job of protecting the basketball in this half, just as they did in the second half against Arkansas.
They adjusted
to the tempo.
Actually, they've controlled tempo a little bit. Here in the second half by handling the ball well.
1 minute to go. Winner goes to New Orleans.
I think you somehow clear the floor and try to let Donald Williams get to work.
Phelps is going to have to hurry the shot. Montross at the other end. Here's Gibson. We're tied.
What a kick out to a teammate.
Reese fires to Lynch. No! 0.8 tenths
of a second left. Dean Smith calls time.
Can you take a look at Lynch? It won't go. And the ball knocked out by Nelson.
This Camel's system is so adaptive, it can travel 50 miles in desert heat without taking fluid, making it one of the world's most dependable animals. This automobile system is so adaptive that if necessary for your safety, it is engineered to travel 50 miles in desert heat without a single drop of coolant, which might also tell you something about its dependability. The Seville STS with a North Star system by Cadillac. Changing the way you think about American automobiles.
Life. Around every corner, financial questions. Choices. Surprises. When you need direction, the Principal Financial Group can guide you toward your goals. With flexible insurance, solid investment strategies, stability you can count on. No wonder people have been coming to the Principal for over a century. To secure your future, to get an advantage, get the Principal Edge. The Principal Financial Group.
This symbol outside means you have the standard inside that an entire library of software has been written to. The Intel microprocessor. Think of it as a library card that lets you run the software of today and tomorrow. So check out computers with Intel, the computer inside.
For many, the search for the world's greatest tuna sandwich ends when they discover Subway's Tuna Sub right here at Subway. One taste of the combination of our famous fresh baked bread, chunk light tuna, and any or all of our famous fresh fixed fixins, and it'll hit you too. This sandwich is worthy of the title World's Greatest. And now it's an even bigger deal with a special $1.89 price. So come get hooked on the sandwich that's a tuna fish wish come true.
The 6-inch tuna sub. $1.89 for a limited time at Subway.
Shelley Long's got a marriage problem.
Nobody else ever mattered to me. None of them.
None of them?
Good advice. Premieres Friday.
If your son is the head coach at the Cincinnati Bearcats, it's a little tough, too. We have 8/10 of a second left. Time has been called again, this time by Cincinnati. And here is the play, Clark, that tied it for Cincinnati.
Well, Phelps trying to force a shot. Montrose gets the errant shot, but quick hands by the Bearcats. And Terrence Gibson had already went out. All five white jerseys in the paint. He got an easy one, and that put us where we are right now.
There's Bob Huggins' wife. Family a little concerned. Timeouts now, one each. North Carolina, 10 team fouls. Possession arrow, Cincinnati, 8/10 of a second left. What do you like here?
Well, I think you've got a chance to shoot a jump shot if you get Donald Williams off a pick. It's got to be a catch and shoot. Or maybe you put the onus on the officials by trying to throw it inside into the paint right away, put it up in the air, try to let Reese or Montross go upstairs and get it and finish in one motion. So you've got a couple of options. 0.8 seconds is close to 1 second, so you can actually, with a good solid screen, get a catch and a shoot. I think one of those two things will happen if you're Cincinnati. You got to try to pressure the ball in these close quarters and then communicate on any screens.
Derek Phelps will throw it in for North Carolina.
And you really just have to worry about challenging the first shot without fouling because there's no chance for a putback.
Montross, a final word of advice from Dean Smith.
Well, we saw him come up with one of those backdoor plays at a key point in the game just the other night against Arkansas.
Martin will defend the inbound pass to be made by Derek Phelps. Out of the wing is Donald Williams, and then a stack on the right side of the free throw line. Montross, Lynch, and Reese. 8/10 of a second remaining. Derek Phelps will inbound.
Thank you.
would have counted.
Granite gray of Wall Street. The boundless blue of a Paris morning. The radiant reds of an Australian sunrise. In celebration of a new style of service at home and abroad, we now embrace the colors of the world as the new colors of United Airlines. Come fly the airline that's uniting the world. Come fly the friendly.
Misses the jam as the horn was sounding. Now, did the horn sound before the shot was released? Jody Sylvester just looked over to us and said, it was good if it went. Listen to the horn and watch the clock.
Yeah, I think that was the right call because he actually got it off a fraction of a fraction.
Jody Sylvester also just looked back at Hank Nichols, the director of officials, and said, I'm really kind of glad we didn't have to make that call. But Sylvester just indicated to us that it would have counted had the basket gone. Cincinnati in overtime. 1-0, North Carolina. First overtime game of the year. Cincinnati beat Miami of Ohio by 6 in overtime on February 1st.
Well, you have to remember the guys in foul trouble, Montross, Blount, and Martin and Blount for Cincinnati, Montross for North Carolina, all with 4.
We talk about a game, Clark, of surging emotion. What does that do for a North Carolina team?
Well, I tell you what, I just think you got to wipe it out and just get ready for these next 5 minutes. I don't think it favors anybody either way. It's been a hard-fought, well-played, intense battle, and now it comes down to the basic elements of winning basketball games. Executing, defending, rebounding, making...
Like that one by Corie Blount. Williams kicks it back out to Lynch. Gets it back. Reese trying to shake the memory of that shot. Gets it underneath and the basket is good by Lynch. He's got 21. Cincinnati's ball.
Well, you look at Dean Smith. He's been active over there. Weak side forward again, Nelson. Boy, maybe he got a piece, but they claimed it was off Montross at the very end. Well, you just had a play where you got Blount a good look inside.
Van Exel throws it away.
Trying to penetrate and create, but Blount, Montross really can't fight him because he's got the 4 fouls, so it would make sense to try to find a way to let him touch it in your half-court set.
Phelps, no. Montross. Williams!
Boy, I sense a little frustration in the Cincinnati guys. They've had a couple of lapses defensively here to start the overtime, and they're a little down with one another. They need a hoop for adrenaline and confidence now.
Blount looks inside for Terry Nelson, settles for Eric Martin. 13 on the shot clock. Van Exel, or rather Gibson. 18 turnovers for Cincinnati. And a 3-point North Carolina lead with 2.5 to go.
Cincinnati's gone a little flat, Byrne. I'm just looking at their eyes, their expressions. They've lost a little starch. A basket here by Carolina could be devastating.
On the shot clock. 2 minutes remaining in overtime. And Carolina up by three on Donald Williams' basket. He takes another. That may do it. Time has been called by Cincinnati.
Before the Pathfinders, before the Explorers, even before the Cherokees, there was Blazer. Now the first sport utility vehicle of its kind offers you all this and the performance of a 200-horsepower V6. You can spend thousands more on something else, but there's only one way to get the experience of a Chevy Blazer, the vehicle that originated the species.
Cellular One has set up state-of-the-art cellular service that reaches clear across America. Beautiful, isn't it?
It has a powerful overhead valve engine. Smooth 5-speed transmission. Has the best resale value of any make. And comes with a 30-day money-back guarantee. The cost, just $1,999. It's the John Deere 12.5-horsepower STX 38 lawn tractor. At just $1,999, it's our lowest price ever.
A noble warrior advised, the art of protection springs from within. One must stay vigilant against one's unfragrant perspiration, lest one provoke a hostile response. Thus, a Norse ritual is Rygaard Sports Stick, an aromatic array of the freshest scents and maximum protection against disarming wetness. Confirming the wisdom, the best defense is not to offend. Rygaard Sports Stick. Anything less would be uncivilized.
Bobby Hurley, Chris Webber, and Jason Kidd are among today's college stars who got their start at the McDonald's All-American High School Basketball Game next Sunday on CBS.
Carolina hit only one three-pointer in regulation time. They have hit two in overtime, both by Donald Williams. They're up by six, and coming up next, from Seattle, Temple against Michigan. The winner of that game joins three others in the Final Four in New Orleans. Dean Smith trying to make it back there for the ninth.
Well, Cincinnati has certainly played on their heels the last two possessions defensively, a little frustrated with one another. They desperately need a basket here to regain some confidence.
Montross is on the bench. Salvador in the lineup for North Carolina. Van Exel. Boy, he has been frigid in this half, as frigid as he was torrid in the first 15 minutes of the ball game.
Well, they tightened it up on him defensively. He didn't get nearly as many looks here in the first half as he got in the second half.
Timeout was called by Carolina. They were having problems with the 10-second clock. 1:21 remaining.
I just love raisins in cereal.
I'm afraid you don't.
If I say I like raisins, I do.
No, I really don't think so.
Yeah, well, what do you call this, pal?
Not this.
Kellogg's Raisin Bran?
Hey, if you really loved raisins, you'd be eating Kellogg's Raisin Bran.
So, you really think you got something here, eh, buddy?
Two scoops of our sweetest, plumpest, juiciest raisins.
Mmm, what was I thinking?
Kellogg's Raisin Bran. If you love raisins, this is your cereal.
Mmm, now on there's two scoops, eh, Duke?
You know those credit card commercials where they tell you to jaunt off to some exotic paradise? This isn't one of them, okay? We're taking our MasterCard to the supermarket. How's that for exotic? Actually, I guess it is kind of exotic. I mean, you've got a MasterCard, they've got tropical fruit and crystal clear water, right? And now, no card is more accepted on the planet, including supermarkets. And it's smart to use your monthly statement to keep track of your grocery spending. I mean, the supermarket isn't exactly paradise, but at least you can drink the water. MasterCard, it's more than a credit card. It's smart money. America's
Welcome to Napa, America's most complete source for quality auto parts and accessories. And now get hot spring buys at Napa. Quality Napa motor oil, 99 cents a quart. Get two Silverline oil filters, just $4. Colorline spray paints, $1.99 each. And Napa's lawn and garden battery, only $19.95. Save big on hot spring buys now at Napa, America's first choice.
Olympic gold medalist Franz Plummer leads a field of downhill legends at the American Ski Classic next Sunday on CBS Sports.
Ryan Reese of Carolina missed a dunk shot at the buzzer that would have given the Tar Heels the lead and the victory. But Don Williams has come back with 2 3-pointers in overtime, and Carolina's up by 6, 74-68. Nick Van Exel, brilliant first 15 minutes of the ball game, problem six.
Yeah, he shot 7 of 14 in the first half, including 6 threes, only 1 of 8 this half. He's gotten a couple of good looks, but Carolina, Donald Williams and Derek Phelps have done a nice job limiting his good shot attempts.
Brian Reese has to call timeout. That is the final Tar Heel timeout. 74-68.
Choosing your first new car sure can be complicated. There are cars that promise you safety. Cars that are well-built and well-backed. Cars that won't leave you stranded. Cars that give you a break on the price. Even cars that help with your down payment. But Chevrolet makes it easy to get all of the above. And the Chevy Cavalier, the lowest-priced car in America with standard anti-lock brakes. Test drive Chevy Cavalier today at your neighborhood Chevrolet dealer.
Look, it's Mark. He likes to run out in the sun. He runs past cows and fields and trees. Runs past fat guys with TVs. Rains can rain, dogs can bite. Stop, he won't, he'll run all night. So he wants shoes cushy and light. Then he'll feel the runner's joy you can't find in a lazy boy. I like to run, he says with a smile. I think I'll go another mile.
Just a high-performance tire. It's a Michelin. So it does things ordinary tires just can't do. The XGT series from Michelin. Because so...
Tar Heels are out of timeout. Cincinnati has one remaining possession arrow. Favors North Carolina, and they have a six-point edge with 1:21 remaining. Phelps gets the inbound pass from George Lynch. Now Donald Williams goes by Terrence Gibson.
No need to foul. Donald Williams is looking for a foul. And he was shuffled his feet. He certainly did. Donald Williams was anticipating a foul, and Cincinnati surprised him by not fouling. They basically just huddled around him, which was good defense. They give up 13 seconds. Take a look here and watch Donald Williams' feet. He's hovering over the ball, wanting to actually get fouled, and there he shuffled him at the very end. So now you need a quick hitting shot. It doesn't have to be a three unless it's a good one if you're Cincinnati. Well, you can't go this casually, though.
There's Gibson.
They're looking for the three.
There's Van Exel. He's one of nine. And the foul and the rebound, Eric Martin. George Lynch is the foul. Tar Heel. Martin, he leaves with 16 points, and he's not yet aware that he has fouled out. Now he will be.
I think he knows. He's just not anxious to leave. That's a very empty feeling. And it's time to sit down and foul.
George Lynch will go to the free throw line. The coordinating producer of NCAA basketball on CBS is Bob Dekus. Today's game produced by Mark Wolf and directed by Sandy Grossman. Coordinating producers of the road to the Final Four, Eric Mann and David Winter, directed by Bob Matina. The senior producer of CBS Sports is Ed Gorey.
Well, what a tournament Eric Martin had, not only in the first and second round games, but here at the Meadowlands as well. Double-digit scoring in all four games.
Rebound, Carolina. What a play by Derek Phelps.
Smart play, heads up play here by Belt. On his way out of bounds, catches Nelson right on the knee. It's tough to catch the orange with your legs.
Point 7 seconds remaining. Montross can't save it. And traveling called. It'll be Cincinnati's ball.
They still got life.
They sure do.
North Carolina's really struggled to get the ball inbound here the last three possessions.
Nelson, Van Exel, Durden, who is a pure shooter, is in the lineup, along with Gibson and Blount. Gibson tries to get the screen back to Blount. He'll get it in the corner for Nelson. No. Lynch with the rebound. 35 seconds to go.
Well, not the guy you want is shooting the three.
Casual pass again. Van Exel takes it all the way. It will not go for Nick Van Exel.
There's Nick Van Exel Sr. wondering where is that invisible lid. Bearcats couldn't quite find the hole here in this overtime. But another outstanding season for the Bearcats. It'll be hard to deal with immediately afterwards, but when they have a chance to pull back and look at what they've been able to accomplish, they'll take pride and satisfaction in this season.
Phelps gets one. 3 points for Phelps.
A numb feeling now for the Bearcats and their patrons.
One of two. The lead is seven. Cincinnati has missed its last seven shots. Salvadori, Phelps, Carolina has won. Last basket doesn't count, but it's irrelevant. Donald Williams gets 2 3-pointers in OT. 6 of his total of 20 in the ball game. And North Carolina goes up against Kansas Saturday afternoon in New Orleans. It'll be a number 1 seed against the number 2 seed. Our most valuable players of the game for Chevrolet, Don Williams of North Carolina and Nick Van Exel of Cincinnati. For Clark Kellogg and Andrea Joyce, I'm Vern Lundquist saying so long from the Meadowlands. Our final score, 75-68. Pat O'Brien and company will be along when we come back.
There's a luxury car so exclusive, many people don't even know about it. Only a certain number are produced each year. Their owners enjoy an incredible level of quiet and impeccable road manners. But despite all efforts, word is getting out. Which means now, probably everybody's gonna want one. It's your money.
And so the celebration and the T-shirts continue out at the Meadowlands as North Carolina has advanced to the Final Four. They will play Kansas next Saturday, and nobody is celebrating more than Brian Reese. I'll guarantee you that. It's 8 minutes of tip time in Seattle for Temple and Michigan. One more team to go to the big dance in New Orleans. We'll be back with more on the road to the Final Four right after this. Stay with us, folks. Great basketball today.
You know, a lot of fellas my age are afraid of change. Me, I'm impressed by new technology, like this car, Subaru Impreza. It's new thinking in building a car, not radical change, advancements. My friends might not appreciate.
North Carolina fans' hearts are still fluttering. North Carolina advances to the Final Four. They'll play Kansas. Let's go back out to the Meadowlands. Andrea Joyce is with, I presume, a happy Dean Smith. Andrea?
You bet they are. Thanks, Pat. Coach, congratulations. What was your message to the team going into overtime?
Well, I hope we can continue to play the way we did in those last 4 minutes. And we really had a chance to win in regulation, but we concentrated. I thought we got good shots because Donald made the threes. But it's an exciting victory because Cincinnati is so hard to play against. They're very strong defensively.
The rematch of the 1991 Final Four against Kansas. How tough is it for you to face your former assistant, Roy Williams?
I will hear that all next week, but I'm so happy for Roy and his team, and I'm happy for this team and our coaching staff, and we'll tee it up when.
All right, we'll see you in New Orleans. All right, back to you, Pat.
Thank you, Andrea. Good job. And, Coach, congratulations. We'll see him in New Orleans.